Here's what I'd like to do. You pointed out some issues that you were concerned about, and I thought that maybe you could go and look into it a bit more, and you did. And so why don't I turn things over to you so that you can tell us what you found out.
Okay. Well, thank you, Michael. Hi again.
Hi.
Thank you, Michael. So I did go and I started trying to deal with these issues. So just to recap a little bit, there were two problems that I had, more or less. And they were that we had all these cool little randomized optimization algorithms. And most of them seem to share this property that the only thing that really happened over time is you started out with some point and you ended up with some point, which was supposed to be, you know, the optimal point. And the only difference between the first point and the last point that you did, or the 1,000,000th point, or however many iterations you had, is that that point might have been closer to the optimum by some measure. And very little structure was actually being kept around or communicated. Only the point was being communicated. Now, you could argue that that isn't quite true with genetic algorithms, but really you move from a single point to just a few points. The other problem that I had is that we had all of this sort of probability theory that was underneath what we were doing, all this randomization. But somehow it wasn't at all clear in most of the cases exactly what probability distribution we were dealing with. Now, one thing I really liked about simulated annealing is that you were very clear about what the probability distribution was. So what I decided to do is to go out there in the world and see if I could find maybe a class of algorithms that took care of these two points for us. And I found something. You'll be very happy to hear, Michael.
Yeah, I would love to find out what it is.
It turns out that I wrote a paper about this almost 20 years ago.
How did you find that?
I just said, well, if I wanted to start looking someplace, I should look at home first. And I stumbled across this paper that I wrote.
I see. So learning about machine learning really begins at home.
That's exactly right. So I had to reread the paper because, you know, it is a couple of decades old. And I will point out that a lot of other work has been done since this that refines on these ideas. But this is fairly straightforward and simple. So I think I'm just going to stick with this work. And the paper is available for everyone listening to this right now or watching this right now. So you can read it in all of its gory details. But I just want to go over the high level bit here because I really think it kind of gets at this idea. So in particular, the paper that I'm talking about introduced an algorithm called MIMIC, which actually stands for something, though I forget what. And it really had a very simple structure to it. The basic idea was to directly model a probability distribution.
Probability distribution of what?
Well, I'll tell you. And, you know, like I said, Michael, I will define exactly what this probability distribution is for you for a second, and hopefully you'll buy that it seems like a reasonable distribution to model. And given that you have this probability distribution that you're directly modeling, and the goal is to do this sort of search through space, just like we did with all the rest of these algorithms, and to successfully refine the estimate of that distribution. And the idea is that if you can directly model this distribution and refine it over time, that that will in fact convey structure.
Structure in particular of what we're learning about the search space while we're doing the search.
Exactly. And not just simply the structure of the search space, but the structure of the parts of the space that represent good points or points that are more optimal than others.
Yeah, that seems like a really useful thing.
So I'm just going to give you, again, this simple MIMIC algorithm that sort of captures these basic ideas because I think it's fairly simple and easy to understand while still getting at some of the underlying issues. But do keep in mind that there's been literally decades of work since then in the optimization space where people have really taken these kinds of ideas and refined them to sort of be much more mathematically precise. But this, I think, does get the idea across, and I happen to understand it, so I thought that I would share it with you. Seem fair?
Yeah, that sounds really exciting.
Excellent.